Hey, it's Mikey back again with another camo guide. Today it's for the geometric camo on the Sigma 2 launcher in Black Ops Cold War. Geometric is destroy 50 ground base score streaks or vehicles in multiplayer. If you enjoy these guides, please take 3 seconds to hit that like button. It really helps me continue making videos for you guys. If you haven't already, you should have maxed out your launcher in zombies before playing multiplayer, as many of the challenges they can be combined. In this case, it's the stripes, geometric, flora, science. They're all about destroying score streaks. So why work on 4 separate challenges when you can do them all at once? So for the air support, you can hang back, use cold-blooded. That's going to help you out. But with geometric being the hardest of all the score streak challenges, that is what this video will focus on, with lots of gameplay for you guys to study. But it's basically the same class for all of these challenges. So first up, the best mode for all these challenges, and mainly geometric, is Combined Arms. This is Cold War's version of Ground War. It's the big team mode with up to 24 players. So that is up to 12 people all calling in spy planes for you to shoot down. The maps are big, so you can just chill at the back of the map using cold-blooded. But with geometric being the hardest of the score streak challenges, that is what we're going to focus on. So first, I will give you guys the class, and then we'll go over some gameplay. Primary can be anything that you want. The one thing I will talk about is the attachment, the barrel, cavalry lancer, or whatever it happens to be on your weapon. Just whatever that you have that will increase vehicle damage. This isn't a must, but it can help. Sigma, of course, we do have danger close. That is going to give us 2 smokes, 2 lethals. For the field upgrade, we are running the assault pack. For our perks, perk 1 is engineer, then on perk 2 we have gearhead, and perk 3 is ghost. Well, that's for geometric, otherwise you'd run cold-blooded, but really ghost is a decent all around for all the score streak challenges. In my opinion, the best 2 maps are Crossroads, the snowy map, and then Armada, the big map with the battleships. Lots of vehicles, and that means lots of opportunities. And in this clip, you can see right off the rip, 3 easy vehicle kills from the snowmobiles, and a big part of that is because of the setup that we are running. Engineer perk, must have, lets you see equipment and streaks through walls, through smoke, and hey, that's where the smoke comes in handy. Danger close, wild card, gives us the 2 smokes, 2 nades, 4 rockets, 4 instead of 2 rockets, so this is perfect for what we're trying to do. You can toss out your smoke, and it may give you time to aim your rocket before the driver, the pilot, whatever, before they can notice you. So it's really good against tanks. And speaking of tanks, that is what the nades and the cavalry barrel are for, dealing damage to the tank or vehicle before you launch your rockets at it. It's not always necessary, but it can help in certain situations. To help give us more rockets, that is where the assault pack field upgrade comes in. You get bonus score from the ammo, but more importantly, it refills your rockets and it stays on the map a very, very long time unless the enemy destroys it. And so that leads us to perk 2, gearhead. It speeds up the cooldown on our assault pack and gives us the ability to hold up to 2 of them. That's amazing. And the final perk is ghost. So remember, the other challenges, they're really easy. It's the geometric challenge of destroying ground vehicles. That's going to take some time. So if all you care about is air support, just swap out ghost with cold-blooded. Ghost is what's going to let us flank or get into position to hit vehicles as they come out of their spawn. So on Crossroads, hanging out somewhere along the midpoint, either the extreme to the left side, to the right side, or maybe right in the middle, I just wouldn't get into their spawn, kind of hover just outside it. On Armada, the big battleship map, sometimes I would swim out out into the open. Makes it, people aren't really looking for you out there. That is where ghost comes in. There's a lot of snipers, the gunners can see you, so I would hide out there, maybe go into water sometimes. It's all about being sneaky. So even though destroying jet skis and snowmobiles, it's not really hard. You just have to be patient and you have to position yourself on the map so you can get the kill before someone else steals it or the person jumps off the vehicle. I've got lots of gameplay for you guys to watch so you can get a feel of how to complete this challenge. And with that said, the next video will be focused on the psychedelic camo challenge. And then after that, we will have the full guide. So please take 3 seconds to no-scope that like button if you want to watch live. Link to the Twitch down below, but let's just get into some gameplay.
These guys will probably jump off immediately. But you see all these people on vehicles? Like, it's like pretty much guaranteed that they're gonna get on them. People are more likely to use vehicles in this mode than in, fire team. Out of ammo here. There you go. Losing Charlie. Oh sh. What's my teammate doing? He's just chilling, huh? What the hell just happened here? This guy jump off the cliff? Enemy has Charlie. Hostile spy plane established overhead. Hostile spy plane. Yeah, it's like if I have cold-blooded, I'll get spotted by UAVs. Vice versa, choppers will see me. We're losing this fight. I'm not sure what's better yet. I really don't. Those guys want to get a triple right now. Ooh, never mind. Like, they were taking vehicles, tanks, and all kinds of stuff. Now they're just kind of chilling.